Finally, one morning, there's a sign in the grasslands that the time of scarcity is coming to an end. The first zebras, the ones opening the way, are already grazing near the Mara River. And the hunters go on the move. Considering that they're the targets of the savannah's greatest predators, the zebras certainly wear very flashy coats. But it must be a pretty good design, since every species of zebra wears it, with slight variations. There are three species of zebras. The mountain zebra, the rarest of the three, lives in southwestern Africa. The Grevy's zebra is found in Ethiopia and northern Kenya. And the Burchell zebra, the most common, ranges over much of southern and eastern Africa. They all wear stripes, and their stripes help all of them to survive. But how? The answer probably lies in the eyes of their greatest enemies, the lions. Lions are able to see in almost total darkness, but they don't distinguish colors very well. The zebra's stripes break up their silhouette and make it hard for the lions to decide which animal to attack. If the zebras start to walk or run, all the lions see is a mass of stripes that conceals each individual zebra in a confusing tangle of clashing lines. And since they also have difficulty distinguishing colors, the end result is a stripy mirage that completely befuddles the lions. When the zebras arrive in the Masai Mara, the great hunters stop stalking and chasing smaller prey. For the cheetahs, it means the end of a period of unsustainable competition. With great difficulty, this mother and her three grown cubs have managed to survive the harassment of the lions and hyenas, and now they can finally concentrate on their usual prey, the Thompson's gazelles. A few zebras mingle with the Thompson's gazelles, but our mother shows no interest in them. A hungry cheetah could try to catch a zebra foal, but the adults are definitely beyond their reach, and their young aren't easy prey either. The gregarious behavior of zebras protects the littlest members of the herd. If a cheetah comes too close to the herd, the zebras close ranks and establish a safety zone to keep it at bay. And if the cheetah still tries to approach the herd, the zebras show it what they're capable of. Our female doesn't even try it. She crosses in front of the zebras with her eyes already fixed on another target. Just ahead, within striking distance, thanks to her amazing speed, stand her favorite prey. And cheetahs are the best hunters among all the felines.